Here's a quick tip for tennis players to help decrease knee pain, hip pain, back pain, and shoulder pain, and also increase your performance on the court when hitting forehands and backhands. Now, when you go to hit a forehand and you take the racket back, your hip has to be able to internally rotate. Let me make that make sense to you. When you take a backswing, your pelvis, ribs, torso, shoulders, everything turned this way while your leg is fixed on the ground. So your leg is effectively rotated inwards in relation to your upper body. So your hip needs internal rotation to be able to take a backswing. If you can't do that, then other areas have to compensate for that lack of movement in your hip, and that can cause aches and pains. It can also decrease performance as well, because the biggest muscles in your body wrap around your hip, like your butt and so forth. So if you can't get that movement, then you're going to lack power when hitting a forehand. The same thing goes for a backhand. You need to have internal rotation on the leg that is fixed as you take a backswing to hit a backhand. If you don't have that internal rotation, as I said, aches and pains can result and you can lack performance. So one of the easiest things you can do to increase hip rotation or internal hip rotation is massage the hip rotator muscles, which lie on the backside of your butt. I'm just going to coach Christina to lie on the ground. She's going to use a tennis ball to massage those muscles. So these are the muscles of the hip rotators that come from the spine and the pelvis and go to the outside of the upper leg. When they're flexible enough, they enable the leg to rotate internally, or the hip socket to rotate internally, which is going to help with that internal rotation needed for tennis. So she's going to place that ball on the butt. She's going to find a sore spot. She can increase pressure by placing the ankle of the side she's on the opposite knee. She can tip out towards the ball to increase pressure. When she does that, the opposite side of her pelvis is going to come off the ground slightly. So she can support that with the left hand. So she's sliding her left hand underneath her pelvis. And she's found a sore spot, and she can stay on that sore spot for 10 to 15 seconds until it starts to release. She can then scooch a little bit to find another sore spot. Got one? Perfect. So she's releasing the hip rotator muscles. She's also addressing the gluteus maximus muscle, which is also responsible, when it is flexible, for helping internally rotate the leg. So she's going to do each side of her butt, doing those hip rotators and the gluteus maximus muscle, for 2 to 3 minutes, for a total of 5 minutes for both sides of the butt and hip rotator muscles. And that's going to help increase hip rotation, which is needed for tennis, to decrease, obviously, all those aches and pains that are resultant if she can't internally rotate the hip. And it's also going to increase her power in both her forehand and backhand on the tennis court.